National memory, because it is the day when modern India was born. Under Mahatma Gandhi's moral and political leadership, the National Congress passed the Puran Swaraj resolution demanding complete independence from British rule in December 1929. Gandhiji organized worldwide celebration on 26 January 1930 as Freedom Day. From then on, the nation took a pledge on this day every year to carry on the freedom struggle till we attained. Exactly 20 years later, in 1950, we adopted our charter, modernity, the constitution. Tragically, Gandhiji had been martyred 2 years before, but the framework of the constitution that has made India a role model for today's world was constructed out of his philosophy. The essence lay in four principles: democracy, freedom of faith, gender equality, and an economic upsurge for those who trapped in the curse of dire poverty. And these have been made the guiding values of our country. Being living in democratic republic, we have freedom in mind, faith in words, pride in our heart, and patriotism in our soul. So let's salute our nation on its 73rd Republic Day. Now I would like to invite teachers of the school for singing a medley song.
Thank you.
hear valuable, inspirational and motivational words to enlighten our listeners.
Now, I would like to invite the Honorable Principal Ma'am to share her valuable, inspirational and motivational words to enlighten our wisdom.
Dear parents, teachers and my students and other staff members, we all virtually present here to celebrate the 73rd Republic Day of our nation. I wish you all of you a very happy Republic Day. This is a great occasion for all of us. We should congratulate each other and pray to the God for the development and the prosperity of our nation. On this day, we know that Indian Constitution came into the effect, and we should understand the real meaning of Republic Day. What is the meaning of Republic? The Republic means the supreme power of the people living in the country, and only people have the right to choose the leader, the prime minister of the nation. The law has come up into the effect which given us a freedom to select our leader itself. We got freedom in 1947, but still our rules and regulations being followed by the British people itself. So 1950, we got our constitution, the law, and certain responsibilities and duties written under it. So the real freedom comes when we have our own rules to follow. You have your own house, you have your own rules, the policy, and you feel free to do what you like to do. The same in the nation where the constitution came, that is, Indian constitution gave us a right, but and how we are going to choose our parties or the selection of the leader and the prime minister. We need to understand a beautiful Asian thought, which is given by our people, that the performance of the duty protects our rights, and the rights cannot be divorced from the duties itself. We should respect the national flag, the national anthem, obey the laws of the country, preserve the cultural heritages and the environment as a good citizen. We should understand, if we want to see the India as a developed country, we need to understand every person should follow the duties. As it is written in a Bhagavad Gita itself, karma is the worship. Your duty itself is your puja. If every citizen takes it in a very positive manner, where we have to perform our duties, the day is not far where we can see the India among the most developed countries itself. So I would pray to the God to get the prosperity and the development of the country once again before that we call up as a golden sparrow of the world. So I wish you all a very happy Republic Day once again. Jai Hind. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Your message was really heart-touching, and we will try to implement the same in our lives.
आज मैं आपको रिपब्लिक डे से रिलेटेड एक पॉइंट सुनाऊंगी. देखो बच्चों, झंडा प्यारा, तीन रंगों का मेल है सारा. सदा रहे ये झंडा ऊंचा, आकाश को ये रहे छूता. सदा करो इसका मान, कभी न करना इसका अपमान. झंडा है देश की जान, बना रहे ये सदा महान.
My name is Anantvi Singh. I study in first A class. देखो बच्चों, झंडा प्यारा, तीन रंगों का मेल है सारा. सदा रहे ये झंडा ऊंचा, आकाश को रहे ये छूता. सदा करो तुम इसका मान, कभी न करना इसका अपमान. झंडा है देश की जान, बना रहेगा सदा महान. जय हिंद.
स्टार्ट. हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज रितेश. आई लिव वेरी हैप्पी रिपब्लिक डे. देखो बच्चों, झंडा प्यारा, तीन रंगों का मेल है सारा. सदा रहे ये झंडा ऊंचा, करो तुम इसका मान, कभी न करना इसका अपमान. झंडा है देश की Nishan. Jai Hind. Thank you.
My name is Krisha Sood. I am from first class. Today I am here to present a poem on the public day. Desh mere desh, desh mere desh, desh mere desh. Tera kitna pyara naam hai, kitna pyara naam hai, kitna pyara naam hai. Hamera hai tujhpe tere jhande ko salaam. झंडे को सलाम है, झंडे को सलाम है, देश मेरे देश तेरा कितना प्यारा नाम है, हमें गर्व है तुझ पर तेरे झंडे को सलाम है। तीन अंक से तेरा तिरंगा सफेद रहा और केसरिया, तीन अंक से तेरा तिरंगा सफेद रहा और केसरिया, किसमें सच्चाई हर खुशहाली केसरिया बलिदान है, देश मेरे देश तेरा कितना प्यारा नाम है, हमें गर्व पतेरे झंडे को सलाम। नेकता में एकता है भारत की विशेषता है, भारत की विशेषता, नेकता में एकता है भारत की विशेषता, सुबह यहाँ की सदा नहीं है, यहाँ नहीं हर शाम, देश मेरे देश तेरा कितना प्यारा नाम है, हमें गर्व पतेरे झंडे को सलाम है, झंडे को सलाम है, झंडे को सलाम, जय हिंद, भारत माता की जय, धन्यवाद।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम, माय नेम इज जसलीन फॉर क्लास सेकंड ए। आई स्टडी इन गुरु नानक फाउंडेशन पब्लिक स्कूल। यहाँ की मिट्टी भी है प्यारी और आसमान भी है प्यारा। हम बुलबुले हैं इसके ये गुलस्तान हमारा। कहने को तो ये तीन रंगों का धागा है, कहने को तो ये तीन रंगों का धागा है, वो तिरंगा तो मुझे मेरी जान से भी प्यारा है, वो तिरंगा तो मुझे मेरी जान से भी प्यारा है। किसी को हीर प्यारी है तो किसी को प्यार प्यारा है। इंसानियत की नजर से तो पूरा संसार प्यारा है। पूरी दुनिया की मोहब्बत को तुम एक तरफ रख दो, मैं फिर भी यही कहूँगा, मुझे मेरा हिंदुस्तान प्यारा है, मुझे मेरा हिंदुस्तान प्यारा है। जय हिंद।
थैंक यू निशाना पंडित। देखो बच्चों यह झंडा प्यारा, तीन रंगों का मेल है सारा। देखो बच्चों यह झंडा प्यारा, तीन रंगों का मेल है सारा। सदा रहे यह झंडा ऊंचा, आसमान को रहे यह छूता। सदा करो तुम इसका मान, कभी न करना इसका अपमान। झंडा ही देश की शान, बना रही है सदा महान। देखो बच्चों ये झंडा प्यारा, तीन रंगों का मेल है सारा, तीन रंगों का मेल है सारा। जय हिंद।
माय नेम इज हरनीत कौर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू सिंग अ पैट्रियोटिक पोएम ऑन रिपब्लिक डे। आई कम फ्रॉम लैंड ऑफ सेजेस with a culture rich from ages. I know the value of zero. My soldiers are my hero. The material spared the cost. I love my country most. With the golden sparrow flight, I will take it new height. Not pundit, not jut. I am Indian first. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Morning to all. My name is Sarav Sani from class 3C. I am going to represent a poem on Republic Day. Freedom in minds, faith in words, pride in our hearts, memories in our souls. Let's salute the nation of the Republic Day. Happy Republic Day. Thank you.
A very warm good morning to respected principal ma'am, teachers and my dear friends. My name is Anmol from 4th A standard. Today I'm going to speak a patriotic poem due to the 73rd Republic Day celebration. My India is my pride. I pledge myself to nation right when I was born. Come if my situation, I will fight the raging storm. I idolize my soldiers with love in every breath. The tricolour on their shoulders fills passion in my blood. To brighten up its future, I will toil day and night, diverse and rich in culture. My India is my pride. My India is my pride. Thank you and have a nice day. Jai Hind.
माननीय प्रिंसिपल साहिबान, अध्यापक साहिबान और मेरे प्यारे साथियों, मेरा नाम एकमजीत सिंह है। मैं चौथी कक्षा का छात्र हूँ। आज मैं आपको गणतंत्र दिवस के शुभ अवसर पर एक कविता सुनाने जा रहा हूँ, जिसका शीर्षक है तिरंगा। तीन रंग का नहीं ये वस्त्र, ये ध्वज देश की शान है। हर भारतीय के दिल का यही तो स्वाभिमान है। यही गंगा, यही हिमालय, यही हिंद की जान है। तीन रंग में रंगा हुआ ये अपना हिंदुस्तान है। ये अपना हिंदुस्तान है। जय हिंद।
सुप्रभात, मेरा नाम सार्थक सूद है। मैं पांचवी एक कक्षा का छात्र हूँ। आज मैं आपके सामने एक कविता पेश करने जा रहा हूँ, जिसका शीर्षक है गणतंत्र दिवस। 26 जनवरी को आता हमारा गणतंत्र दिवस, जिसे मिलकर मनाते हम सब हर वर्ष। इस विशेष दिन भारत बना था प्रजातंत्र, इसके पहले तक ना लोग थे पूर्ण रूप से स्वतंत्र। इसके लिए किए लोगों ने अनगिनत संघर्ष, गणतंत्र प्राप्ति से लोगों को मिला नया उत्कर्ष। गणतंत्र द्वारा मिला लोगों को मतदान का अधिकार, जिससे बनी देश भर में जनता की सरकार। इसलिए दोस्तों, तुम गणतंत्र का महत्व समझो। चंद पैसों के खातिर अपना मतदान मत बेचो, क्योंकि यदि ना देश फिर से हो जाएगा प्रतंत्र, तो आओ हम सब मिलकर ले प्रतिज्ञा। मानेंगे संविधान की हर बात, ना करेंगे इसकी अवज्ञा। जय हिंद। धन्यवाद।
नमस्कार मेरे आदरणीय शिक्षकों और मेरे प्रिय दोस्तों, आज मैं आदित्य चौबे कक्षा पांचवीं ब का छात्र माखनलाल चतुर्वेदी की देशभक्ति के से ओतप्रोत कविता, जिसका शीर्षक है पुष्प की अभिलाषा, सुनाने जा रहा हूँ। चाह नहीं मैं सुरबाला के गहनों में गूथा जाऊं, चाह नहीं प्रेमी माला में बिन प्यारी को ललचाऊं, चाह नहीं सम्राटों के शव पर हे हरि डाला जाऊं, चाह नहीं देवों के सर पर चढ़ूं भाग्य पर इठ लाऊं, मुझे तोड़ लेना वनमाली उस पथ पर देना तुम फेंक, मातृभूमि पर शीश चढ़ाने जिस पथ जाए वीर अनेक।
गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर टीचर्स एंड माय डियर ऑल फ्रेंड, टुडे आई एम स्पीक अबाउट ह्यूमन राइट्स। आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम एवरीवन टू द 6th annual celebration of Human Rights Day. Our NGO was established 7 years ago with the purpose protecting the rights of common people, as well as supporting the poor and deserved people. For all those who are new to our NGO, about the background of Human Rights Day, adopted in the year 1948 by the United Nations General Assembly. It is observed every year on December 10th by the international community. The day is usually marked by high-level political conference and meeting, as well as by culture events and which deal with the issue of human rights. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Good morning, respected principal, ma'am, teachers, and all my dear friends. I am Gurpreet Kaur from class 7B. Today I am here to speak some lines on five fundamental duties. Five fundamental duties are: first, protect and improve the environment; second, protect our public property; third, to respect the national flag and national anthem; fourth, to cherish and follow the noble ideas which inspired our national struggle from freedom; fifth, to uphold and protect the unity and integrity of India. Fundamental duties are important for every citizen of India. Thank you and have a nice day.
Everyone, I, Jasleen Kaur, student of class 8th, is here to share my views on fundamental right to education. Right to education, the importance of learning, is to enable the individual to put his potentials to optimal use. Education makes man a right thinker and a correct decision maker. It achieves this by bringing him knowledge from the external world, teaching him two reasons and acquainting him with a past history so that he can be a better judge of the present with the education. He finds himself in a room with all its windows open to the outside world. A well-educated man is more dependable worker, a better citizen, a center of wholesome influence, pride to his community and honor to his country. A nation is great only in proportion of its advancement in the education. Over the years, demand for children's education has grown by leaps and bounds. Everybody from the poorest of the poor to the well-off acknowledge the value of education in the overall development of children. Basically, the object of education is threefold: physical, mental, and spiritual. A perfect system of education must do full justice of those three above. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning, everyone. I heard Sprit Kaur from class 8A. Today I am here to share my views on right to equality. Right to equality is one of the six fundamental rights in the Indian Constitution. It includes equality before laws, prohibition of discrimination on grounds of race, religion, gender and caste or birthplace. It also includes equality of opportunity in matters of employment, abolition of untouchability and titles. In simple words, we can say it is the right to live with equal opportunity. It simply treats all people to be same and nobody can get a special privilege which will dishonor any individual or group. As per Article number 14 of our Constitution, it guarantees that all people shall be equally protected by laws of country. Right to equality not only applies to the citizen of India but also to all the people within the territory of India. Every citizen from prime minister to an ordinary individual is subjected to the same laws. All citizens have access to people, places like shop, restaurant, hotels, multiplex, similar, no restriction will regard it to use all well roads, playgrounds and places of public resort maintained by government. We should always treat rich and poor, high and low, equal before the law, but the judiciary must be independent and impartial if the rule of law can mean everything real. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning, respected principal ma'am, teachers and my dear fellow friends. Myself, Noorjot Kaur from class 10th. First of all, I wish you a very happy Republic Day and I would like to thank you, my teacher, for giving me opportunity to speak about this special day. Republic Day is celebrated every year on 26th of January. Today we are celebrating our 73rd Republic Day. Republic Day is the national festival of India. It is very proud day for our country because on this day the Constitution of India came into force in 1950. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar is the father of the Constitution of India. On this day our flag is hoisted and national anthem Jana Gana Mana is sung. Republic Day Parade is a big event conducted at the Rajpath in New Delhi. The President gives award to the brave soldier and the people on this day. Republic Day is celebrated in school and colleges with a great joy. Thank you and once again I wish you a very happy Republic Day.
Hello everyone, my name is Yashwar Chaudhary. Today I am going to speak on the topic Right to Information Act 2005. The Right to Information Act was passed by the Indian Parliament on June 15, 2005 and came fully into force on 13 October 2005. According to Act No. 22 of 2005, the Right to Information Act is an act to provide for setting of the practical regime of right to information for citizens to secure access to information under the control of public authorities. In order to promote transparency and accountability in the working of every public authority, the constitution of Central Information Commission and State Information Commission and for matters connected therewith or incidental thereto. Since every citizen pays taxes, therefore he is entitled to know how the government is functioning. The Act empowers every citizen to seek any information from the government, obtain copies of any government document, inspect any document, works and records of the government, and take certified samples of materials of any government work. On July 2019, the Minister of State for Personal, Public Grievances and Pensions, Mr. Jitendra Singh, introduced Right to Information Amendment Bill in Lok Sabha, which proposes to give the centre the power to set the salaries and service conditions of information commissioners at central as well as state levels. Thank you.
Good morning to everyone who is present on the prosperous occasion of Republic Day. Myself, Rupinder Kaur from Plus One Science from Guru Nanak Foundation Public School, Mohali. Today, I am going to speak on the topic, the First Amendment to the United States Constitution. The First Amendment to the United States Constitution prevents the government from making laws which regulate an establishment of religion or that would prohibit the free exercise of religion or abridge the freedom of speech, the freedom of press, the freedom of assembly, or the right to petition the government for redress of grievances. It was adopted on December 15, 1791 as one of the 10 amendments that constitute the Bill of Rights. The Bill of Rights was proposed to assuage anti-federalist opposition to constitutional ratification. Initially, the First Amendment applied only to laws enacted by the Congress, and many of its provisions were interpreted more narrowly than they are today. Beginning with Gitlow v. New York, 1925, the Supreme Court applied the First Amendment to states, a process known as incorporation, though the Due Process Clause of the 14th Amendment. The Free Press Clause protects publications of information and opinions and applies to a wide variety of media in Near v. Manista, 1931, and New York Times v. United States, 1971. The Supreme Court ruled that the First Amendment protected against prior restraint pre-publication censorship in almost all cases. The Petition Clause protects the right of petition all branches and agencies of government for action. In addition to the rights of assembly granted by this clause, the Court has also ruled that the amendment implicitly protects freedom of association.
तेरा मेरा साथ यही तक था ये तेरी जमीन तेरे खून से ही तो सजती संवरती है रांझे तेरे इश्क की मैं हकदार नहीं तेरी हीर तो धरती है रांझे तेरी मिट्टी में मिल जावा गुल बन के मैं खिल जावा इतनी सी है दिल की आरज़ू तेरी नदियों में बह जावा तेरे खेतों में लहरावा इतनी सी है दिल की आरज़ू सहे महफूज रहे तेरी आन सदा चाहे जान मेरी रहे न रहे ऐ मेरी जमीन महबूब मेरी नस नस में तेरा इश्क बहे फीका ना पड़े कभी रंग तेरा जिस्मों से निकल के खून कहे हाय तेरी